Good morning, all of you. Welcome to Sadhana series. So, before starting the lecture, let's take a blessing from Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, sir. Also, our Guru, our God, Dr. Praful Vijaykar, sir. So the next chapter is additional miasm. So we all know how many miasms we have. After going through so many lectures, you all are aware of three miasms. But also we have heard many other miasms like tubercular miasm, cancer miasm, etc. So why there are three miasms? I will go very quickly through this because you have already learned this in the previous lectures. So this is a quick review for all of you. So we have heard many other miasms like tubercular and cancer miasm. Why only three miasms? Because there are only three defense mechanisms in the living cells. Already this is taught to you. Why only three defense? Because there are only three functions in the living cells. These three basic functions of a cell help in the defense. So what are their defense? Survival of cell, which is physiological. Survival of species, which is reproduction, mitosis. Survival of both individual and species, defense system. Fighting to destroy and survive. So there are three defense. I would like to share two examples. This is, you all must be knowing. So first example written in by Sir in his book, that there is Mr. X and Mr. Y, right? Mr. X and Y are sitting beside each other. Mr. X is poking Mr. Y on his arm. And Mr. Y is very timid, very docile. So he is not reacting, but he is reacting just moving hands, which is a defense by him, which is a psoric defense, and there is an inflammation, which is psora. After poking so much, he started doing, Mr. Y, he kept a pillow as a defense, that it might not hurt him more. So there is a second defense, which is psychosis. Third defense, he still kept poking him, Mr. X. So Mr. Y decided to cut off that part, which is syphilis, to destroy and save the whole. Next example, which Sir always used to share with the patients, shoe bite. So when you wear a new footwear, there is irritation, there is an inflammation. If you don't take care of it, it turns into a thick skin, which is psychosis. And if still you kept wearing the same footwear, it turns into ulcer. So from this, you keep this in the mind. So you will understand this very easily. What is physiological defense? What is survival of species reproduction? And what is defense system fighting to destroy and survive? In physiology, Sir has explained already. So in the previous lectures also. So when any bacteria enters into the cell, the defense system starts. How? The body itself has a bacterial agent inside the body. So whenever the bacteria enters into the body, body starts secreting to kill that bacteria, which is the physiological defense. And it is possible with the help of ATPs, with the energies. Then second defense comes, there is an accumulation. And finally, if it is not taken care, there is a destruction. So, first function of the cell, survival of cell, physiological function to survive, what we need, nutrition, respiration and excretion to produce energy, ATPs. So when this nutrition is sacrificed, there is always a first defense, which is a psoric defense. Second function of the cell is survival of species by reproduction. By mitosis, When mitosis is altered, there is a cytosis in defense. Third defense is survival of both self and species. In this, the immunity is involved, and when this immunity is altered, the syphilitic defense comes. That is in two ways: either it attacks others or attacks self, which is autoimmunity. So there are only three defenses. Because there are only three functions in the living cells, there are only three myosins. There cannot be more than three myosins. Now let's talk about tubercular myosin. So-called tubercular myosin. Let's see tuberculosis of the lungs. It is a disease at a pathological level. It expresses in three different stages. So when the tubercular bacilli enters into the lung tissue, first there is formation of inflammation of pleura, which is called pleuritis. Itis is inflammation. So first defense is pleuritis. In the next defense, if this pleuritis is not treated, then lung tissue starts forming tubercles, granulomas, which is accumulation, which is the second defense. And third is, if it is not treated, then it goes into third defense, which is cavitation of the lung. You can see here, cavitation of the lungs, which is again syphilis. So tuberculosis itself has all three mechanisms, all three defense while fighting against the bacteria. So according to sir, no need to confuse the system, and better to keep a, rather to call it as a tubercular diathesis rather than tubercular myosins. And also, if you see for the same physiological stage, Sorokin stage, tubercle formation, cytosis, and cavitation is destructive, syphilitic. Thus, TB involves all three defense mechanisms, hence it is a product mixture of all three myosins, hence no so-called tubercular myosin is soro, cytosis, and syphilis. This condition can be more or less termed as a tubercular diathesis rather than tubercular myosin, which is misnomer. Another example, cancer. So if cancer, though cancer is a genetic mutation, it also starts with irritation at the tissue level, then it proceeds into induration, growth phase, and then terminates into ulceration. So same three mechanism follows in cancer also. So no need to give a name. Now this is in aphorism 74. Dr. Hanneman said, in order to maintain the life against this inimical and destructive attacks, it must produce a revolution in the organism, either depriving sensibility or exile this to an excessive degree, which is a soric defense. Causes dilatation and contraction, relaxation or indigestion, which is psychosis, or even total destruction of certain parts, and develop faulty organic alteration here and there in the interior or the exterior, which is syphilis. So this is written by Hanneman sir 200 years ago in his book. In today also in our modern science, they also said there are three basic defensive mechanism when the any bacteria virus enters into our body. So it stands test of time. So since 200 years it is proven to be true, right? Also, after explaining all the process, how the cell survive, definitely it has a scientific background. Then all three mechanisms reflects at the physical level, mental level, and pathological level. So it is a holistic science. So this is end of this chapter, additional myosin. Now we'll go to the next chapter. Behavior pattern of all three myosins. So first we'll start with Sora. So both on mental and physical plane, it have a certain pattern. Behavior will be influenced by following properties. This is Soric: sensitivity, irritability, hypersensitivity, anxiety, apprehension. Sensitivity, irritability, hypersensitivity, anxiety, apprehension. This is all Soric behavior. But what is psychotic behavior? There are two types: psychosis excess and psychosis less. So psychosis excess behavior includes exaggeration or excess of expression, deceitfulness, slyness, show off, pseudoism, collective tendency. Psychosis less: hiding, quietness, secrecy, slyness, deceitful, deception, soberness, less intellect or morals, and undercoverness, which is less expressive. Psychosis less. And what is syphilis? This behavior will have a stem of destruction, distortion, and perversion, which is out of control. Now we have to study this pattern. All these behavior patterns are the defense mechanism. Whatever we behave, we act, it is our defense for survival of self. This can be basic natural traits inherited from birth or developed and acquired during the lifetime. Every individual defends according to his underlying mechanism. What does this mean? Inherited behavior. That means, this is also example given in the book. So suppose mother or child, having mother who is very conscientious, diligent, working all the time, caring, taking care of family, children, very solid mother. And also, and the father is like very not taking care of anything, very irresponsible, dire. So very psychotic trait of father. Now how child behaves, that decides that he dominated which genes, mother's gene or father's gene. So in the situation when the child reacts, his behavior would tell us whether it is inherited or also there are cases where it is acquired during lifetime. What is acquired? So in the surrounding which you live, according to that the child or the person starts behaving. So there are two types of natural traits: either it is inherited and one is acquired. And every individual behaves, defends according to the underlying mechanism. If person is soric, his reactions are soric. If he is psychotic, his reactions are psychotic. If he is syphilis, his reactions are syphilitic. We'll see the more examples. All the emotions and intellect are defensively oriented in the world. It is not up to behavior, but also emotions and intellect also defensively oriented in the world. So this reaction to the particular situation will reflect the underlying mechanism. The reaction to the situation will be completely different in different mechanism because the defensive method is different. Read it again. The reaction to the situation will be completely different in different mechanism because the defensive method is different. What does this mean? For example, there are three kids in the family. The situation is same. There is only one situation. Suppose there is a fight between the parents. The first kid, he will start weeping. He will get scared, he will start weeping. He is a very sensitive child. He will feel for it. He will feel hurt, sad. Okay, number two. The second child will go and sit in the corner. He will not come out. We need to push him, we need to console him, which is psychotic reaction. And the third child, he doesn't care. He just go out and play. So it's completely indifferent. So all the three kids have different myelium empty base. First was the psoriatic child, second is the psychotic, and third was the syphilitic child. Now let's study from the book. Sir gave example of mischievousness. What is mischief? Is defined as that activity which might harm, damage, or injure, causing annoyance. Mischief is defined as that activity which might harm, damage, or injure, causing annoyance. But harm is psoriatic, damage is psychosis, injury is syphilis. So what is psoriatic mischief? Example, child is hiding a pen or a handkerchief of a friend. So there is no damage or no injury to others. He is just mischievous, which is very psoriatic. Psychotic mischief. Those children or even adults who play mischief, which in a long run may cause damage to the one's prestige and may be painful. Which is a psychotic, because social position. It causes damage to the one's prestige, which is psychosis. What is syphilitic mischief? Child who has placed a pin pierced through a cardboard pointing upward on the set of a teacher, knowing very well that the teacher always sat in the chair with the force. And when teacher did so, it hurts him so badly, so as to give pain and bleeding. So this is a syphilitic reaction, which is causing injury. Injury to somebody is syphilis. So concealed or hiding important papers or the files of a person about to go for an interview may cause tension or distress for the concerned person, especially when he does not know who has done it. Another example. Concealing and hiding an important paper or the file of a person about to go an interview. This is the situation. This happened. But in this also, response to this situation, how the concerned person behaves also depending on the myosins. So either person will start searching a file, will become anxious, and if not found, he will start weeping. What is this behavior? Psoriatic behavior. He will just start searching, become anxious, and starts weeping. Psychotic reaction will be looking out for the file in anger, will go on thinking what alternative step he should take. He will find a way by manipulation or bribing his way instead of presenting the file in the interview. So he will use his brain in a different way, not conscientiously, which is a psychotic reaction. Syphilitic reaction. What is syphilis? He will just lose the hope. He will let go the interview. He will go into complete despair. So there are two syphilis also. Either they go into despair or the reaction got heightened. So second reaction could be hysterical syphilis, in that he loses his temper to an extent of breaking and throwing things, which is hysterical syphilis. It's a part of syphilis which is out of control. One is complete destruction of one part, one is out of control. So the losing hope is a just, he went into despair. There is a despair, and in the hysterical it is something which is out of control. Another example is positivity. So you understood about mischief, psoriatic, psychotic, and syphilitic mischief. Next is positivity. Even positiveness can be present in differently in three different defense mechanisms. The positiveness of the individual who go ahead in the life also shows miasmatic differentiation. For example, pyrimethamine and arsenicum album, which is very conscientious. Their conscientiousness overweighs their other character to make them positive. They are the one who will do their work meticulously according to rules and regulation, with all the paperwork nearly done so that there is no flaw. Thus, march positively towards their goal and acquire the success, which is soaring. The shrewd planning, cunning mind of Lachesis or Mercury or Poseidon, psychotic Poseidon will find way and mean to get over the obstacles. So even the remedies, there are three miasmatic remedies which you will learn in the next chapter. So the shrewd planning, cunning mind will find ways and means to get over these obstacles, which is a psychotic behavior. If same like is Mercury causticum, if having a predominance of syphilitic youth will blast their what through troubles to achieve their goals. So they can go out of control to achieve their goals. So same Mercury, same Lachesis, same causticum, you can see in syphilitic miasm also. So we'll study few more examples. What is soaring anxiety? So anxiety is a concern or solitude respecting some event, future or uncertain. It is a concern which is related to some event, future, and which is uncertain. Future, not present, not past, but the future. Aage kya hoga? Which disturbs the mind and keeps it in a state of painful uneasiness. It expresses more than uneasiness or disturbance, and even more than trouble and solicitude. So anxiety is a concern respecting some event, future, and uncertain, and it gives painful uneasiness. For example, usually in clinics, patient calls and we feel very annoyed to take the call. Why? Because the ladies will start a conversation, "Doctor, I'm having leg pain since 2 days. I feel it is vitamin D deficiency. What do you think? Should I get it checked? And also, doctor, I am having migraine since 3 days. And I am having acidity also. Do you think my acidity, migraine is correlated? Do you think any test I required? Doctor, I am having this problem. Doctor, my hands are paining." So much they talk, but only about health, which is purely anxiety for health. Suppose you are not taking care of this anxiety. Still she is anxious, she is worried about her complaints. Then one day she will come and this soaring anxiety may turn into psychotic fear. So now she will say, "Doctor, I think I am having a cancer or some major illness of heart." So this fear of something misfortune, fear something will happen to me, then the same anxiety can convert into fear, into psychosis. And if this is not taken care, then there is a call from the husband, "Doctor, she is not sleeping since 3 days. There is excessive perspiration. She is just walking here and there. What is this reaction? She is very panic, anguish. Let's see the definition. Fear: the feeling that you have when something dangerous, painful, or frightening might happen. She started feeling that she is having cancer. There is no cancer, but that fear came into worse. In present scenario, lot of people are saying fear of infectious diseases. Similarly, what is anguish? Anguish is excess or extreme pain of mind. So the intensity is 3 times than the anxiety. Any keen distress from sorrow, remorse, despair, any reason and the kindled passion. It is worth bearing in the mind that nowadays it referred to as a panic attack. So it is one of the same panic attacks and anguish, which is more syphilitic than the anxiety and fear. We take irritability. Anger and rage and fury. You all know irritability. Irritation, anger. What is rage? Biken with fury, frantic and frenzy. Violent anger accompanied with furious words, gestures or agitation. With furious words, gestures and agitation. This is violent anger. I'm talking about anger which is very violent. So violent anger accompanied with furious words, gestures or agitation. Anger excited to fury. Then this violent anger can convert into a fury. A rage. This need to be distinguished from anger violent. The anger rubric referred in general more to feeling. It's more of a feeling. Anger is more of a feeling, while the rage referred to behavior. There's a difference between anger and fury. So here the anger is a feeling and the rage is, you will see, in behavior. While a patient may report that given to feelings of violent anger, this may not be visible to others as the loss of control implicit in the rage. I'll give you an example. So one child came to the clinic. He was having 102 fever. And he was sitting independently on the chair. Mother was in the next chair. He was completely red in color, completely red with 102 fever. So just asked, why he is so much angry? So mother said, there was an incident last night. He was playing and one of the girl, there was an argument with the girl. He was around 8, 9 years old. And there was an argument with the girl. And in that argument, that girl slapped him. Now this child is very angry by nature. He also wanted to slap her back. But mother came in between and took him to the house. He got so angry on mother, he started hitting mother very badly. And he was angry that why you didn't allow me to hit or slap her back. And that was his anger. In the same anger he slept, and next day morning he got high fever. What is this? So when there was an argument, was going on between the two, he was irritable. When she slapped him, he developed anger. When mother stopped him, he went into rage and fury. He started hitting mother like anything, which is a behavior. Anger was the feeling. Because she slapped him, he felt the anger, which is a feeling. But when mother stopped him, he went into rage, fury, because he started hitting her very badly. Understood? The argument is irritability. The feeling is anger. But the behavior goes to first stage. Now, let's say another example of sadness, hurt, offended easily. So that child we talk about, there is a fight in the family. Those who are very sensitive, they easily feel hurt. If someone is talking loudly with them, they feel immediately offended. They become sad, which is a somatic reaction. If this hurt is not removed, then they can go into this grief stage. They keep brooding about that event. They keep thinking about that. This is psychosis. So, where is the Sora? Hurt. Over the period of time, if not treated, they may go into despair. For example, there was one lady who was hospitalized for low hemoglobin. Okay, so many medications given by us by the hospital, but she was not improving. What was her reaction to this? She was suffering a lot. She was having fever, body pain, weakness. She was not able to eat anything. She told her husband that, "I'm not going to live now. You don't take the pain for me. I'm not going to take any medications now. Not even homeopathy, not even allopathy." What is this? Complete hopelessness. She went into complete despair. She was hurt that nothing is helping her. She cried. She was thinking about her complaints. And finally, she went into a despair. Complete discouragement, despair. So, what is remedy for this? Irritability, argument. So I gave her salt. It started with irritability because it was completely red in color. So mock salt was, there was salivation, hot, thirsty, very angry child. At this despair, it's a big rubric, despair. Then you can see a further, cannot be held, and you can prescribe on this. Now next is affectionate. Showing great warmth, love, fondness, attachment, extreme attachment, which is soaring. You always like a child who is very affectionate. You like to take that child because they are very loving, they are very caring, they come and hug you, they will greet you, they will pass a smile to you. So this is affectionate. What is lovesick? And amativeness. Amativeness is more related to high sexual desire. And lovesick means a child asking for hug and kiss every 15 minutes. Every 10 minutes, every 15 minutes, he is going to mother and asking hug, kiss, which is lovesick, which is excess. So psychosis. And syphilis, the love converts into perversity. What is perversity? Homosexuality. Loving own sex or our sex with animal. So love perversity. Sympathetic. Sympathetic means having common feeling with another. Susceptible of being affected by feelings like those of another. Having common feeling with another. Susceptible of being affected by feelings like those of another. Or feeling in consequences of what another feels. So suppose this, her friend is in pain. She would also feel the same sadness, same pain. She would not smile. So same. This is sympathetic. If girl is seeing some beggar, she becomes sad. This is sympathetic. So, common feeling of another. What is benevolent? They become benevolent. They start giving. They start helping, which is psychosis. And later there is a superlative is pondering. What is pondering? There is no control on spending. They keep spending. There is loss of control. They keep spending. A very common example we see complaining. A child who is very complaining. Once the child comes from after playing, she did this to me, she did that to me. So many a times, but this pure complaining is sola. It turns into quarrelsomeness. In psychosis, they start fighting, quarreling, and also then it can increase and then turn into reproaches others, they blame others, curse others, which is most severe. Timid, very bashful. What is timidity and bashfulness? Very shy. Means a child, when any strangers or relatives come, they go and hide behind the chair. They hide behind the sofa. Hide behind the mother. They don't give eye contact. These are timid people, bashful people. Usually they go into psychosis very covert. They will not fight for themselves. In company, the boss, the colleague take advantage of them. Because they understand, but they cannot fight because of timidity. They become covert. And if this continues, then they lose their identity. What is loss of identity means? They cannot take decision. The head goes to others. Whatever others tell, they follows that. So they go into loss of identity. So this is how behavior pattern of every miasm is different at every stage, and even in one particular situation you will get three different reactions, different behaviors. Now why we are learning this? What is significance? Why we are learning this behavior pattern of miasm? Why this is important? Behavior pattern of miasm. Why we need to know for a physician a behavior pattern of each and every miasm? Yeah, so first is from the behavior you can judge that this person is soro, psychotic or syphilitic from the behavior of the patient. First, the underlying miasm you can judge from this learning. What is second? This will help you, especially in chronic cases. When you see the chronic cases, you will get a many behavior, different situation and different behavior in different situation. So in one situation, the reaction is very solid. Another situation, reaction is psychotic. One more situation, reaction is syphilis. So how this will help you? How understanding of behavior of miasm will help you in selection of rubrics? Suppose you are having a case of some autoimmune disease, some syphilitic disease, autoimmune disease, then you have to consider syphilitic behavior. Then if you If you know what is psychotic behavior, what is syphilitic behavior, then only you will be able to choose the right rubric. So this is the syphilitic rubric. So you have to enter through syphilis. Suppose some kidney stone, gallbladder stone, some psychotic pathology has come to you. And you have got SORA also, psychosis also, and syphilitic behavior also. So what you will take in psychosis? So first, always give preference to syphilis, because psychosis goes into syphilis. So if you consider the syphilis and cure the psychosis, result will come. But also if syphilis is not present, you can enter through psychotic but not the psoriatic behavior. And if the person comes with the SORA, you can consider psychotic rubric also, syphilitic rubric also. So the selection of rubric is very important, but before that you should know what is SORA, what is psoriatic behavior, what is psychotic behavior, and what is syphilitic behavior. And accordingly, by taking case, you can differentiate psoriatic behavior, psychotic, syphilitic, and by selection, you have to consider syphilis first, then psychosis, and then SORA according to what you are treating. I hope everything is clear. So we are ending this lecture here only. So I would like to thank Ambik sir, Tarang sir, for giving this opportunity to be a part of Sadhana series. And thank you all of you. Thank you so much.